Hi friends, welcome to Real Talk with Pinks. We are on our second episode. Thank you so much for the love that I saw you guys gave to the show and all those people who subscribe to the show on YouTube. Today we are going to discuss the challenges of starting a small business, and I'm really excited. A guest that we have to say is one of my that we have today is one of my good friends. Never mind the Khuabat. One of my good friends, Thato Lekatsa. So she will be talking about the challenges of starting a small business. I just want to introduce her before we get into the show. Thato, thank you for coming to the show. Can you just introduce yourself to our guests and tell us now, Thato Kima?
First of all, I want to congratulate you, Pinks. This is kind of cool. Anywho, Joloka Hassan Shalusisa, my name is Thato Lekatsa. And I'm a businesswoman, also a motivational speaker. I have a show on radio where I motivate aspiring business people and also youth as a whole. Okay. So yeah, that's just me in a nutshell.
Oh wow, that is nice. That's really, really nice. Yeah, so today we're going to be discussing the issue of challenges of a business. Thato is one of the people that quit her job. She was working full-time and then she decided to follow her passion. So she is going to run us through what made her quit her job to start the small business, because we know here in Lesotho a lot of people are unemployed. And at that time, to be honest, I personally thought she was crazy, because I didn't understand how can you quit your job when so many people are looking for jobs. So first of all, my friend, I just want to ask, what made you quit your job and go into a business full time?
Thank you very much. I was actually excited when you approached me about this topic, because it's one of those topics that are very dear to me, because most people, really, the first thing people ask me, Thato, why did you quit your job? You know, so it's just one of those that I love dearly. So it's not even something very hard. What happened is, I've been working where I was working in the government sector for 6 years, and I felt most of the time like a caged eagle. Mm-hmm. I knew that I have this energy in me, but for some reason I just couldn't exhaust it, and I just didn't know why. So for about a year, I started trying to figure myself out and mm-hmm. just know who is Thato and what is it that she wants, what can make you happy. Mm-hmm. So I discovered myself in more than a year. I would just come to the work and just do my job, and now try to Google certain things, just finding yourself, really, just finding so I tried looking for tools that can mm-hmm. help me discover who I am, because I mean, you can't do anything if you don't know who you are and what you're about. So mm-hmm. for me, purpose was the ultimate thing. Mm-hmm. So I first discovered who I was, and then when I found myself, I became this crazy person that everyone thought I was. Because now when you know who you are and what you are about and what is it that you want to do, for some reason you unleashed that mm-hmm. eagle that I was talking mm-hmm. about is just unleashed. So really, when I decided to quit my job, I remember very well, it was the 16th of August 2016.
Oh wow.
And I was just seated in my office, and I just felt something in me saying it's time.
Oh, wow.
So I just went like, and the funny thing is, I didn't have really anything properly planned. Mm-hmm. All I knew is what is it that I wanted to do, but I didn't give myself the time limit that by this date and that I will have started or I would have quitted. So I just felt that something in me telling me that now it's time. So yeah,
let's pick up on that. Mm-hmm. You say there's something that told you now it's time. Mm-hmm. I know you are into the catering business, and I want you to explain to viewers, how did you know for sure where you needed to start? Is it because you love food, you love cooking? Mm-hmm. What made you go into the food sector?
Funny thing is, what I'm doing now, it's not the reason I quit.
Oh really?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So here I was thinking I'm gonna set up this huge textile factory. Uh-huh. So that is exactly what I wanted to do.
Oh.
So I knew that when I quit my job and get my money, now I'm going to set up that firm. I wanted to do this textile firm. I don't know if you are aware, but I have this textile cloth.
Oh, yes.
So that was the inspiration behind my quitting 9 to 5. Okay. Yeah. So basically, I did that, and it was as crazy as just picking the phone and asking my HR, how can I, like, I want to quit, what can I do? So no, just write a letter and we'll take it from there. So I did that. I didn't ask anyone. Like, I just, it was just me, like.
That is a really brave step. You took a really brave step. I'm glad I'm not you. So I want you to tell us, immediately after quitting, mm-hmm. how did you start your business? Did you start where you are, we see you today, or how did you get here?
Okay. Like I told you, Pings, I wanted to set up a textile firm, right? So when I quit and I was waiting for my graduates, mm-hmm. thinking that when I get my money, I'm going to be able to set up the firm. But things happened, overpayments, manpower, as you know, and my money ended up being that only which can sustain me for 3 months. Oh, if wow. I can. So it was that bad. Now I had to think, I had to sit down and say, okay, now Thato, you quit your job. Things are not going the way you aspired. What are you going to do, right? Mm. And remember that when I quit my job, the part that I don't want to leave out is that everyone thought I was crazy. Mm. My family, everyone, absolutely everyone. Mm. And they just thought, okay, now, and I was all alone. So mm-hmm. you understand now that if things are not going your way, you can't even go back to them and tell them that now my plans are not going accordingly mm-hmm. because I quit. So this is what I had to do. I remember I had a conversation with my brother-in-law. He called me and asked me, sat me down, said, Thato, why did you quit? Mm-hmm. Then I told him, and he believed in me, but he told me that this thing that you want to do, it's not going to be able to sustain you. Like, it's not going to able to give you money now. Mm-hmm. So you need to come up with something that will sustain you until you build that company. Then he's like, you are a very good cook. Mm-hmm. Why can't you think something food? Then I was like,
that's yeah, a plan.
That's the plan, mm-hmm. you know. So, really, much as I'm a good cook, I love cooking, I never really thought I'll do anything related to cooking as a career or as a business. So when he said that, I was like, oh, okay, let me go back to my drawing board and mm-hmm. find out what is it that I can do mm-hmm. relating to food. So that is when I start thinking about it. So this is what I did. I went home and said, okay, Thato, you are broke. You don't have people around you. People think you are crazy, but now you need money. You need to do something. How are you going to kickstart this? Mm-hmm. That I was like, okay, it's simple. If I can prepare a meal for 10 friends, mm-hmm. why can't I start and just prepare 10 plates and go sell? That is where I can start. Mm-hmm. So I started preparing leaflets, telling people that if you want lunch, order. Mm-hmm. If you want cakes, mm-hmm. order, you know, such things. So then I asked myself, who is going to be my first customer? And then I was like, okay, now that's a challenge. then I was like, okay, it's not even that much of a challenge. Mm-hmm. You see, where I resigned, where I was working,
yes.
they think I'm crazy. They feel sorry for me. So, I mean, they're going to be my first customer. You see, if I come there looking broke like that and just, I'm selling lunch, they have to be my customers. You know, even if I don't cook good food, but they are just going to buy because they are feeling sorry for me. So my office that I was working in were my first customers. So I was like, hey guys, how are you? I'm now selling
selling food
like, really, Thato, now, okay,
come
hey, I get it. No, not really, kepela, hi.
And then you bring them to town.
Then I bring them to town. Oh, okay. I'll know who I'm bringing lunch for 10 people or, you know, so yeah, that is how I started. And Pings, what I want to share with your viewers is that it might seem all funny. It might seem like it was that easy, but it wasn't. Mm. That time when I resigned and people were consecrated, people got like when people left me, I was consecrated, I was all by myself, mm-hmm. and it wasn't a very nice feeling at all. Mm-hmm. I was all alone and people mm-hmm. thought I was crazy. I remember there was a point I asked myself, Thato, do you think you did the right thing? Mm-hmm. And all I could come up with was, yes, most definitely. So, you know, some people quit, they are not sure, and when they face challenges, they start thinking, now, if only I didn't quit. So what made it easier for me when I was struggling, when I was going through hardships, mm-hmm. was the fact that I felt it deep down in my heart that I'm doing the right thing. Mm-hmm. So now that feeling sustains you even though things are becoming hard. Mm-hmm. So I must guarantee, Pings, it wasn't easy. It was very hard. Mm-hmm. You should understand now that I'm married, I have kids, and my husband didn't approve. Like I told you that I resigned. I'm not even saying people should do that, but that is what I did. And I didn't tell anyone, not even even my husband, because I didn't want anyone to talk me out of it, mm-hmm. right? So you need to understand the situation now. Here's my husband, he doesn't approve, mm-hmm. and my family, and now I have kids. I need to help him take care of the kids, you understand? Mm-hmm. So it wasn't easy. Also take care of me, you know. So it wasn't easy. I remember at some point, I looked at myself in the mirror and suddenly my skin was doing things to me, mm. and I believe it was stress related, mm. and now my confidence was shattered. I couldn't go outside now because now I had this skin condition. You know, so you can understand now that I picked up myself and told myself that I'm going to sell these lunch packs, and now suddenly I'm developing this thing.
I want to pick up on something that you said. I like that you always say you had this conviction. You mm-hmm. were always assured that that's the right decision. Mm-hmm. So there was never a point where you doubted that decision. That's the difference about you and so many other people mm-hmm. who start small businesses. Mm-hmm. So you quit your job and now you start selling food mm-hmm. to your ex-colleagues. How did that, Kure, how was the feeling? Because I know as young people, we have our own pride. Mm-hmm. I mean, all of us may want to start mm-hmm. something, but because starting is not easy, mm-hmm. there is pride along the way. Things are not mm-hmm. going well. How was it?
Funny enough, Pings, just after the conversation with my brother-in-law, mm-hmm. now I started seeing Thato beyond where she was now, mm-hmm. you know, and nothing could stop me, not mm. even pride, not even what people had to say. So it was quite easy. I'm a born confident, so mm. it wasn't a problem for me. I knew that as long as I looked good, as long as I have my vision, that is what I always tell people. If you have your vision, it will sustain you, it will keep you going. You don't look where you are now, but you know where you're going. Mm-hmm. So it was quite easier for me. And I remember I could just laugh. Funny enough, people felt sorry for me more than I felt sorry for myself. People were ashamed of for me on my behalf. Thato ka nnete o tlo resign and wana ba o tlo rekisa dijobo strateg, you know. But now I was fueled by my vision, because mm. now I knew where I was going and I knew where I wanted to be. Mm. So it was so easy for me. So ka nnete,
but how long did that process take for you to rediscover, hurry, let me go back to the drawing board, maybe the textile is not working, mm-hmm. maybe let me sell food for now, go from moving from selling those food to your ex-colleagues and now building this empire that we see?
It was probably a year. Mm. I think the whole thing probably
all broke.
Thing I was flat broke. Yeah. The skin condition now that prevented me now to sell. Mm. I remember I was now that time I was broken, because I was like, now I can't go out looking like this. Mm. So I took something like 2 months now, really broken, flat in the house and just crying almost every day. Mm. I remember my mom calling me saying, I have this friend of mine, Thato, how come buy a mosebet? And then I'm like, in that mist, I told her, "Ha ke lo sebetsa, ke tseba handle ntho ke yentseng, you understand?" Mm. So that time also helped me introspect myself and also find myself and reassure myself that I did the right thing. Mm-hmm. So now I have this friend of mine whom I always like thank, because I remember she came over to my house and she found me in that situation and said, "Maybe if you can just try, go for gym and maybe pay gym membership so that you can just regain your confidence." Mm-hmm. And she did that and I went for gym and now my skin started doing nice things. And now I was confident. Now I started, I was unleashed. I was crazy. Nothing was stopping me. I did deliveries, cakes. People were ordering like nothing else, you know, food. Now orders just started
coming in
mm-hmm. like that. So it was really exciting now. So people started thinking, even those, I remember my family started helping me with orders. And so it wasn't, now that maybe that 2 months was just reassurance so that I can run, you know. Mm-hmm. So it was kind of easier now. I was happy. People started trying to make sense of what is it that I was doing.
Mm-hmm. I want us to get into this idea. Lesotho has a high unemployment rate, mm-hmm. especially for young people. Mm-hmm. I wanted to get into this idea. It's all over on social media. Everyone is encouraging young people to start businesses. But I'm one of the belief that we are not all going to go into small mm-hmm. businesses. Mm-hmm. I may start selling something today, but I really like working and climbing the ladder and becoming a CEO, a director mm-hmm. of a big organization mm-hmm. one day. So what's your take as someone who is into business about this idea that go into business if mm-hmm. there's no jobs?
You know, there's something I like. It's a joke, like people just make it as easy as I started out with a feather, now I have chickens. Now people look at me now and think my story is that cute. She started out selling plates and now, you know. But on a serious note, it's not easy. Mm-hmm. You need to have a business thingy. It has to be in you. We can't just encourage people to start business, you know. And I mean, I always say, if now we are all going to start businesses, who's going to work for us? Mm-hmm. Because for business to be sustained, we have people who need to come with the expertise and help us run our businesses now. If we're all going to start businesses, you know. So I think we need to find, I remember I was having a conversation with you earlier this week that we really need to find out what is it that our country can help. We need to establish what is it that our country has so that we can decide now if we are going to go the route, education route, mm-hmm. we need to study what is relevant to mm.
what are the needs
you understand currently. Because it's okay, we need those kids to go to school, we need youth to go to school, mm-hmm. we also need businesses, but now we can't just say, and I very unfortunately people make it as when they tell people to go start businesses, mm-hmm. it's like uhlotswe ke bophelo, now go start a business, you understand, uhutele, you went to school, so now go start a business because there is nothing else that is out there. Mm. So I think what we can do is just to try and establish what is it that we can do as a country to assist our youth and not just try throwing it. Yeah, you know, businesses. So yeah. Mm.
I always say we need to build systems in Lesotho mm-hmm. where the environment can be so conducive for young people to go into those businesses. Mm-hmm. But I really like your story, and I'm sure so many people are encouraged by your story. And it shows that if you're really passionate about something and you believe in it, it can mm-hmm. actually work. So as a round of close off, what would you like to say to other young women, Basotho mm-hmm. women who are struggling in their businesses because of COVID-19, some mm-hmm. businesses closed down. Mm-hmm. So really just encourage them to say, how have you been able actually to sustain your business, and mm-hmm. what would you like to say to them?
I always say vision. Mm-hmm. Vision sustain me. Seeing yourself beyond mm. the obstacles and the COVID-19s and that drive that took me out of that house to go and sell those plates is the very drive that sustained me during the COVID-19 because I felt it at some point. I closed down and it wasn't easy, mm-hmm. but I remembered that I saw myself beyond mm-hmm. The COVID-19. And mm-hmm. so for me, all I can say to women out there is remember why you started, remember what you saw, and that drive will sustain you. Mm. Yeah,
I like when you say remember why you started.
Yeah,
I think that is also my vision for forever. Mm. I always try and remember, even with this show, why did I start? It's because I want these conversations to keep going, for people to know that it's not easy. Just because now we see you with Lekatsa Butchara doesn't mean that's where you started. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much for coming to the show.
Thank you.
I'm really glad that you came, my friend. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. Please do subscribe. We will be bringing our next episode talking about GBV. As we know, we will be celebrating 16 days in the next coming week. Thank you so much. Bye for now.
Bye.